Franklin Graham. Hear me now. You gave a message from Matthew chapter 8, and you said that Jesus rose from the lower decks of the ship, and he said, "Storm, be still." And the storm was instantly stilled. Not slowly, it didn't gradually subside, the storm stopped. Okay, yes, the disciples were on the boat with Jesus, and they were on a boat that wasn't going down. But there's a new way. God is showing the church new things. And listen to me. Listen to me. Okay. Your father said in 1992, I believe, at one of his greatest rallies, one of his greatest messages, he said that the greatest evangelistic campaign crusade in the world, according to the Bible, according to Scripture, was nothing more than Jonah's ministry. God said, this needs fixed. This needs fixed. These guys are suffocating. Go and walk the streets and tell them of my judgment. And the people of Nineveh repented at the teaching of Jonah. No promise of mercy. And your dad said, this could happen here. And he's still with us. Go talk to him about that. But before you do, listen. You're going to Tallahassee. You're flying into Tallahassee. Did you learn anything on the plane? Did you learn anything on the plane, Reverend Franklin Graham? Sir, above you is an oxygen mask. If there's the event of a water landing, okay, the ship's going to go down and hit water. If in the event that we lose pressure, we're suffocating, boom, oxygen mask. Put it on yourself and breathe so you can turn to your neighbor and revive them and turn to your neighbor and revive them. Because if you're suffocating, you can't help anyone. If America is suffocating, what good are we going to be in the world? What good are 10 billion gifts to the children of the world on Christmas if Israel is fallen? What good is it to solve the human migration problems in the Asian countries if there's no jobs in America, if there's lawlessness here, if we are operating like Nineveh? What good is it to do all of these programs and rallies and involve ourselves and throw everything out of the boat so it doesn't sink? We're throwing everything we have, and it's not working. We're throwing everything we have, and it's just like throwing a pebble at the gates of hell. It's throwing a pebble at the gates of hell. And it's prevailing. Why? Because we're doing it the old way. We keep rallying, coming together, and rallying, and coming together, and praying, and offering tithes and offerings, and nothing's working. Why is this, Franklin Graham? Here's why. Because your dad knew the secret of the greatest revival in history. He read the book of Jonah. It's found in Luke chapter 4, when Jesus says, I have come to just proclaim good news, to release the captives, to give sight to the blind. I've come for the oppressed, the sick, the weary. Isaiah 61. It's a new way, but it's old. There's nothing new under the sun. Revival is not new. But here's the thing. Your father was a great minister, but he ministered in a day where we were a righteous nation. We weren't the best, but it was the days of Josiah. It was the days of Hezekiah. The high places were brought down. People were generally good-hearted Christians. They just needed an occasional tune-up. An occasional tune-up. Now we're suffocating. We need the book of Jonah. We need the Jonah Project. We need to literally embrace this. But guess what? It's already been embraced. This is happening. And thousands of pastors around this world are seeing how God is using time to revive, to carry his message to the Gentiles and bring the fullness in. And then the Jews' eyes will be opened. The spirit of jealousy has been let loose. And I pray that it hits you in Tallahassee. Don't go on your prayer rally. Stop in Tallahassee. okay, and get off the boat. You gave a message, and you said, this boat's not going down. Jesus is on the boat. Well, guess what, Pastor Reverend Graham? Jesus got off the boat and walked on the water. And then he said, come on, Peter. And so here's the church. We put one foot in. Okay, is this going to work? Is this going to work? I don't know, but jump in the water and find out. Guess what? A team of about 15 have, and they've been everywhere from London to the Caribbean. They've brought people from Hawaii. They've stirred the hearts of the world. Okay, but they're only 11. If one man, Jonah, can get 600,000 Ninevites to repent, we have a long way to go to reach the 360 million Americans of New Israel. America is New Israel. We are Israel part two. Don't you know that I brought you through the Red Sea? Don't you know I brought you through the ocean to 13 colonies, 13 tribes, and I gave you my laws and I put them in your heart? Okay, so Pastor Reverend Graham, your dad was great, but you can be greater. Walk out that prophetic word your dad gave. Walk it out with Kyle Lance Martin. You're not going to know all the little details. Heck, you don't even know where you're going to go after the fifth capital. I went to your website. You don't even know where you're going to go. You say, I'm disappointed with the Republicans. I'm disappointed with the Democrats. I'm tired of the broken political process. It's not going to help. But you claim that you're going to get Christians involved in voting, but not for any candidate? That's as aimless as it can get. But you go on to say in that same message from Matthew 8, you go on to say, Jesus is the only hope. Jesus is the only hope. Just speak his name. Just speak his name into the atmosphere, and the molecular structure of the nation will change. And it's been changing. It works. In the words of Kyle Lance Martin, it just works. It just works. And your dad recognized that. And he said, it can happen here. He said, that can happen here. He said, Portland, Oregon can be changed. Sarasota, Florida can be changed. The ghettos of Miami can be changed. San Diego, red light districts. Flint, Michigan has been changed. And it's only going to grow. But if we aren't willing to jump out of the boat and fund the kingdom of God, take that Samaritan's purse and just liberally give free will offerings to those who have discovered this secret already that your dad prophesied about all those years ago. Okay? $440 million. Could you imagine what could be done in America? Put on your oxygen mask. Okay? Get off the wooden boat. Okay? The pulpit is great, but that wooden pulpit, it's not going to work anymore. People don't come to church. Ninevites don't go to church. Ninevites don't go to prayer rallies. Ninevites don't go to government functions. Ninevites don't run for local school boards. Ninevites have, we are the Ninevites. The church is the Ninevites. The Ninevites is the church, because 2 Chronicles 7:14 says, if my people will humble themselves, get off the boat, take off our ties and our suits, and just put on a polo and some khakis and walk the streets of Sarasota with Kyle Lance Martin and his team and see what God is doing. And see what God is doing and has done. Until we do that as a church, together with all of our resources, all hands on deck. All hands on deck. I'm a computer programmer from Fort Wayne, Indiana. I haven't worked since June. There's a wildfire burning here. It works. It works, Pastor Franklin Graham. And this is from the Lord. This is from the Lord. You just have to know that. What does God do when things are so bad, when things are so wicked, and everyone's suffocating? He says, go, walk the streets of Nineveh, and proclaim Jesus. Proclaim repentance and mercy. The Ninevites had no promise of mercy. We do. We have Jesus Christ. We have the resurrection power inside us. And we want to go to a rally and tell Christians to vote? You know in your heart of hearts that ain't going to work anymore. You know it, Franklin Graham. You know it. You know it because you said a storm's coming. I don't think so. I don't want a storm coming. God said San Bernardino, boom, and his hand was still upraised. And God said 9/11, boom, and his hand was still upraised, and we didn't repent. And then we light up the White House with the gay pride colors. Paris, boom, and his hand was still upraised. Sandy Hook, boom, and his hand was still upraised. The list goes on and on. It's time to say, I'm done rallying. I'm done trying to get the support of lukewarm Christians. I'm going to step completely off the boat with my Samaritan's purse in my back pocket, and I'm going to walk on the water right up to Jesus and let Jesus himself show me the secret. And that secret is ancient. It just means we're going to get messy, we're going to get dirty, we're going to throw our calendars in to the wayside, we're going to throw our checkbooks to the wayside, we're going to throw everything we thought we knew about ministry, everything we thought we knew about our destiny, and we're just going to go back to 1992, as your father prophesied, the greatest revival in history according to scripture is Nineveh. So walk with Kyle Lance Martin on the streets of Sarasota. Humble yourself. Hey, cut all your hair off. They won't even recognize you. The press can't find you. Just buzz your hair off, put on some shades, grab some a nine iron and a driver and a putter, and have some fun with it. Cancel the rally. Here's the headline. Reverend Franklin Graham has canceled his 50-state prayer rally in search of revival. Why? Because that's what his daddy said. Because that's what the messenger said. Because that's what Kyle Lance Martin has proved. Because that is the way to do it. Ninevites don't go to church. Ninevites don't go to prayer rallies. The church is suffocating. Did you learn anything on that plane? Take the mask and put it on so this nation can be revived. Okay? Ahab's reign is coming to an end. Okay? We're going to bring back righteousness, but it's not the way we thought anymore. I don't know how else to put this. We love you. You are an anointed man of God, Reverend Franklin Graham, and you have no idea what God has in store for you. He has entrusted you with much, so he expects much. Expect great things from God, then attempt great things for God. I'm out. Pshaw!